Hey, Sharon Hornellstrom here, but you can call me Pajama Grandma. Not in my pajamas today with wild and crazy hair, because sometimes life is just a little chaotic and you got to jump into it with both feet. Today, active flexibility. What the heck is active flexibility? Well, I decided as part of the 30-day challenge, that's day four today, just finished the lesson, and as I was creating it, I'm thinking, okay, maybe for an added value, what I should be doing is doing this challenge right along with people, filling out the worksheets, sharing them as a demo for a brand new market and a brand new business and a brand new example. And it's not really new. It's something I've wanted to do for a long time, a really long time. But it's a new market and a new area and a new niche for me. So I think it'd be a really good thing. Now, we're on day four, so I'll have to do a little bit of busy work to catch up. But it's early in the process, so I know I can do it. I can go back and I can spend an hour or two a day catching up and doing it, and then creating examples of how I, as a brand new person, would start this project and would fill out these forms, so that anybody that's saying, oh, I'm brand new, I can't do this, I don't need to do this, I don't need to create a system for handling customers for my business until, of course, I'm well into it. At that point, it's too late. We can do that and just wing it, but it's a lot easier if we have a framework or a blueprint to go off of and we create our business based on that. So I'm going to demonstrate that as part of the process. And that's part of active flexibility, figuring out that once you've started something, there's ways to make it better. There's ways to change it. There's ways to add to it to enhance not only everyone else's experience, but my experience as well. My experience as a coach and trainer and teacher and figuring things out. So that is my active flexibility today. I am going to add that, do that. And I created worksheets and a workbook yesterday. I hate calling it a workbook because people don't want to think of work, but I call it an action book or an action plan or an action item list, because for each day of the challenge, I want you to have at least one takeaway and then one action, which reminds me, I forgot to add the takeaway question. Yeah, it's automatically in the worksheet. I put it out to be in each day's plan, because at the end of each day, I want people to stop and think, or sometime during the day, and say, okay, what is the one thing that I really got out of? What is my personal one takeaway from this day's assignment or action? Today is all about the current situation. What's going on in your business right now with respect to customers? And I want people to just spend 5 minutes going through, answering four or five questions and assessing, hey, where am I at right now? Doesn't matter. Like, as I do this, as I'm thinking about this, which is a good day to start on, and do it for a whole new market, well, my answer is zero to everything, because I don't have anything going on with respect to this new market. And so I kind of want to do that so people feel like, hey, if my answer is zero to everything, I have just as much chance of being successful in this challenge as anyone else, because it doesn't matter. It's just where I'm starting now. And a lot of times, if you're starting from scratch, if you're starting over, you can plan things in a way that supports much more quickly and easily the way you want things to be than somebody that's already got ingrained ways of doing things and it is established, especially if you're established in an organization or a business that already is used to doing things the way they're used to doing them. I work for a lot of corporations, and as a consultant, where I come in and I'm supposed to help fix and change things, well, guess what? People are used to doing things the way they do things, and they don't want to fix things or change things. Change, for some reason, although change is the only constant in our lives, as human beings, we naturally resist change. We want to keep everything the status quo. It's human nature. And so being a change agent or coming in and impacting and making changes is a very tough road to hoe. I'm into idioms these days. But it is. It's hard. It's harder than starting from scratch often. So embrace if you've got nothing going on and know that anything is possible because I'm starting from scratch. So I'm going to demonstrate that. I just decided as I'm talking that I am going to do that. And whether people want it or not, I'm going to do it for me because it's fun and it's moving me in the direction I want to go in this particular area. It's a passion project that I've wanted to do for a long time because I can so relate to the group. And so I'm going to do it. I'm just going to do it. And I got 4 days. I can catch up on 4 days, no problem, even with a three-year-old hanging around. So what are you doing today? It's awesome day, awesome Monday. I love Mondays because I'm going to go jump out in the snow on the deck and it's like thigh high and yell, I feel awesome, and spin around. And hopefully the deck won't collapse. It's a brand new deck, but you never know because there's like lots of snow on it. Anyway, go out, make it a fantastic day. And I will, of course, be with you tomorrow with another update of what I'm working on as I move from the brick and mortar world offline world of real businesses to the online world.